One day in the spring of 2001, we found a tiny little hummingbird nest in the bougainvillea right outside our house, close to a sliding glass door. And although the hummingbird was a little skittish, it didn't seem to mind filming through the glass door. Before long, there were a couple of tiny blue eggs in the nest. Before long, we had babies. With some birds, the father helps out quite a bit, but with hummingbirds, apparently the mother has to do all the work by herself. So she would run around our garden foraging, taking nectar from flowers, come back and regurgitate it in the hungry little babies' mouths. So the little baby birds got bigger and bigger. But one day, Mom didn't return. And so we decided we had to do something.
Let's open up.
The mother must have been killed, or otherwise she would certainly not have abandoned her babies for a day or two. So we finally decided we had to cut down the nest and took the little babies into the animal shelter, where someone tried very hard to recover them, but unfortunately they didn't make it.
Whoa, it's thirsty. Yeah, good. We got in there.
We had better luck about a month later with some swallows who fly north from Central America and Mexico every year and built this mud nest just outside of our front door. And before long, had a healthy litter of 5 hungry babies. Mom and Dad worked together to go out and get food and feed the babies. But there are 5 of them, and it's a big job, and every now and then you just need a little rest. With all of that feeding, they get bigger and bigger, and at some point they're just gonna fall out of the nest. But for now, they like just sitting there together and being fed. How do you get those kids out of the nest and flying on their own? They seem to like it in there. Well, you can't explain to them how to fly because birds can't talk. So the next best thing is to demonstrate it by showing them what it's like and flying around a little bit around the nest and trying to get them to imitate you. And so that's what they do.
Don't sit on my camcorder.
Well, after a day or two of demonstrations, the little babies seem to realize that God gave them wings, and they start to move around in the nest a little bit and fledge those wings just a little bit. Mom and Dad keep demonstrating, and even though one almost falls out of the nest every once in a while, they're still very nervous about getting out into the hard, cruel world. The next morning, lo and behold, they're all lined up on my bicycle, which is just outside of their nest. So, they manage to get out. Of course, they still seem to expect Mom and Dad to feed them. They haven't quite gotten that far. Gradually, they start to make some tentative little flights from the handlebar to the basket and back again. But of course, Mom and Dad still come and feed. They're really pretty little birds, and also seem to be pretty meticulous about cleaning themselves. gradually their flying gets better and better, and they actually seem to start enjoying it and get pretty excited by the prospect of being able to flap their wings and move around almost magically from one place to another. In fact, I'm envious. I'd like to be able to do that, too. It seems so effortless when they do it, even though they've only been doing it for a day or two. Well, okay, it's not always that effortless. They're still learning to do it, obviously. The next logical step is to make it up to the latticing that covers our front patio, as several of them have done here. And finally, they're flying around quite a bit. They make it to the telephone wires behind our house, although you'll notice that Mom and Dad are still feeding them.
Mom's still feeding them.
Anyway, definitely a happier ending this time with the swallows than we had with the hummingbirds. Let's hope we do better with hummingbirds in the future. The swallows have left. They're out of the nest. Although they have left some stuff behind. But they're out there somewhere, flying around, and hopefully by now the little babies have learned to feed themselves. They're gone, and presumably they'll be back next year.